I gotta say, 2017 was pretty great.
Mm. You know, 2018 is gonna be even better.
Hey.
Mm. I gotta tell you, I don't think I'm gonna make it till midnight, though.
Oh, me neither.
You know, we should just record the ball drop.
That's fine with me.
Are you expecting someone?
No.
Ta-da!
Yeah, you know, Mom, I don't want to be negative, but that chimney is way too big.
Yeah, the roof's gonna cave.
Why don't we just use the kit like we always do?
Because, Jack, look, number 5 on my Christmas to-do list, make a gingerbread house from scratch. And here it is. And it's beautiful.
Oh, a gingerbread house.
Yeah.
Oh, the chimney's quite large. It's like a guard tower. are the elves planning on escaping? you could put a little army man on top and you could just cut them down one by one. Then little knives chase after.
Hey, I thought you were gonna get those lights up.
Oh, I was until I saw this. Then I thought I'd untangle it sitting in my chair, which kind of led me to sitting in my chair.
All right, but Christmas is just around the corner and I want to get everything done on my list.
Your list?
Yeah. Now that you're retired, we have time to do Christmas right.
Were you doing it wrong? We wake up, we go to Mass, we open our presents, there was a ham involved. Seemed right. Felt right.
Just take a look at the list before you decide you hate it.
Okay, I hate it.
No. Read it.
I guess I could do a couple of these, all right? No. I'm not putting that Santa sleigh on the roof.
Come on, it's pretty.
Pretty? That thing is a death machine.
Hey, Kyle, what are you doing?
I'm just organizing the mail area.
Well, you don't need to do that.
Well, I ran across some old credit card statements. Couple things jumped out at me.
You really shouldn't be doing that.
And you shouldn't be spending so much on groceries. Don't be ashamed of coupons, Donna.
That's, it's pretty invasive.
Yeah, all right.
Okay.
I'm sorry. I don't want to overstep my bounds.
Thank you.
Oh, but you should know that Jack and I had the talk.
What talk?
You know, the talk, the birds and the bees.
He's only 10.
Well, he asked me about bees, so I thought it was his way of hinting around.
He's doing a report on bees for school.
Well, he might have more info than he needs.
Hey, babe.
Hey.
Can I have a glass of wine? You want one?
I probably shouldn't. Got so much laundry to do. Gosh, those grass stains are just killing me. It's like, what does Mott do? Just walk out the front door and fall down?
Well, a little tip is next time, pre-soak.
Ooh, that's a good one. You know what? Maybe I will have some of that wine.
Okay. Live a little.
Yeah. You know what it is? I'm just tired of feeling invisible. If I'm not cooking, I'm cleaning. If I'm not cleaning, I'm doing laundry. And do I ever hear a thank you? No, I do not.
Well, last night over here, Kyle did the dishes.
That's nice.
Yeah. Because he said I looked tired.
He did not say that to you.
He did. Okay, and you know what? Even if I do look tired, I don't want to hear that. It's like, I want to hear, I look radiant.
Yes! Well, at least you're hearing something. Mott doesn't even talk. Yeah, that's right. I'm not going to compete with the TV. I can't. I just won't. Oh, great. Another load of whites. By the way, they're not going to be white. I got to tell you that right now. When we get in there, we gotta stay quiet, okay?
Well, shouldn't we just go upstairs?
No, the TV downstairs is much better. We can't watch Taken on a small screen. It's an insult to Liam Neeson, and he will find us.
Wait a minute. We're watching Taken again? You've seen it 10 times. You said we could watch Pitch Perfect.
That's when I thought it was about baseball. Once I learned it was about a competitive a cappella group, I wanted to run through a wall into another wall.
Fine.
Remember, stay quiet and don't go near the windows, okay?
Okay.
All right.
This is kind of exciting.
Yeah.
It's so wrong, yet so right.
By the way, if this works out, we should do this with other holidays, right? I mean, like, who really needs Valentine's Day?
Yeah, and why do I have to cook for every Thanksgiving?
Stay calm, they can't see us.
Trick or treat!
Oh, they sound so cute. They're probably little ballerinas or something. I can't. A man is just.
Stop.
What?
Stop. Look at me. The first one is always the toughest.
Oh, that was the most brutal dinner ever.
Oh, 3 hours of him disagreeing with everything I said. I was like, the sky's blue. He's like, no, it's green.
Well, next time, don't say yes to dinner.
Me? He said you agreed.
No, she said you... Oh, they played us.
Like a banjo!
Oh.
We gotta cut them loose.
How are we gonna do that? We don't answer their calls. We don't return their texts. I mean, this is the woman who followed me into the bathroom. Oh, and did you know that they want to take us snowmobiling?
I may have agreed with that. I like playing in the snow.
No, babe, face it. As long as Jack and Graydon are friends, then we are stuck with them. We're gonna end up going to Barcelona.
Unless.
Unless what?
Nothing. Just saying, if something happened and Jack and that kid weren't friends.
What are you proposing?
Not proposing anything, I'm what ifing. What if we did something and Jack and Graydon were no longer friends?
Break them up? That would solve all of our problems.
Right? It is so doable. It's easy. It's easy.
It's so easy. It's so easy. Oh my God, what are we? We're horrible parents.
Oh.
Oh.
So we are horrible people.
Yes.
That, yeah.
Yes.
I'm disgusting for thinking that.
Because this is about Jack.
Yes.
And his happiness.
Yes.
You know, and if we have to suffer through Vic and Brandy, then that's what we gotta do.
Unless.
Unless what?
We find Jack another friend.
A better friend.
Way better.
Robert Beckford. Hmm? Jack loved him, but he lives all the way in Brooklyn now.
They could fill the Belt Parkway with broken glass, and I will crawl over it to pick him up.
Hey. Are you okay?
Yeah, no, I'm fine.
You want to talk about it?
It's his birthday.
Sure, Weasel.
Yeah.
You know, you've forgotten my birthday more than once.
Okay, can we not make this about you, please? Just going through some stuff right now. That's all.
Okay. Why don't you guys just be friends on Facebook?
I tried, okay? I sent him a request to be friends and just nothing.
Someone else.
I will not find someone else.
I'm telling you.
You just don't understand! Donna! Donna!
Hey, lower your voice.
You're sitting on a bucket. What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing?
It looks like you're on lunch break in the back of a Chinese restaurant. Are you hiding from the kids?
And you. Friday night. I'm reading my book. What's the problem?
This is the problem. Right here. And this morning with the kids. Nobody's sitting down for breakfast. You know what it is? We have no traditions.
Well, I do. On Friday nights, I sit on a bucket and I read my book.
Oh.
I mean, until now. Now I gotta find a new hiding spot.
I'm telling you, we are dropping the ball. All right? We gotta start doing things together. Mott's family's killing it.
Oh, Mott. Now it makes sense. Jolly Green Giant gets in your ear and there goes my Friday night.
I'm telling you, we're gonna start doing things together as a family. This is important.
We do tons of stuff together.
Really, name some.
Okay, we go to Mass.
That's one.
Christmas.
Technically, that's Mass.
get on these kicks and you're unstoppable.
This isn't a kick.
Really? How is this different from I'm gonna learn karate and open up my own dojo? Oh.
I pulled a hammy. It set me back a couple belts.
Okay, well, I know I promised that I'd never bring this up again.
Not,
but do you remember?
Stop it.
Let's
Anna.
Grow
no.
our own
nah.
potatoes.
No. I told you not to do
okay,
that.
You ruined our backyard, and it cost $1,000 to grow 4 potatoes that turned out so weird that we were scared to eat them.
Okay. You know what? I love you, but you have zero vision. Do you know how many things you can make with one single potato?
And here comes the
list. I'm telling you, baked potatoes, french fries, potato skins, hash browns. You want Italian? You got gnocchi. Hey, you want to eat healthy? Potato salad. And I'm not even mentioning the all-purpose vehicle of Spuds, the mashed potato. And I know I'm forgetting one, too.
Yeah, you can also make vodka, which I would kill for right now.
No, that is not it. Look, come on. Let's just do this. We'll have fun.
All right. Just don't force things.
I'm not gonna force it, I promise you. Got it! Tater tots! Boom! Shaka Khan! First family tradition, the classic, Monopoly.
Dad,
yes!
We're giving it a shot.
Monopoly, I must warn you, I play at a very high level.
Okay, well, do you want to be banker?
I'm pretty good with money. Yeah,
I'll have to take your word for that, considering I've never seen you with any.
Okay, Dad, are you sure we should do this? Because last time we played, Jack ended up with the thimble stuck up his nose.
I was smelling it. It happened. Get over it.
Well, I don't think that's going to be a problem, because there are no pieces.
All right, love that, Dad.
No, it's okay. Hey, look, we don't need pieces. Or we will make our own, honey. You are a set of car keys. Jack, you are a cheese doodle. Do not smell it. Kendra, you are going to be Kenny Chesney's boot from this magazine. And Sarah, you are a Jets coaster. And Chael, you are a Jets coaster upside down.
Babe, this is crazy.
We're playing.
Okay, we can play. Let's all just hope that Sarah doesn't start crying like she always does.
She'll be fine.
Okay, I wasn't crying, so say it one more time and you'll regret it.
Okay, you know what?
No, wait, I don't know why you're getting mad at me because all the time you're trying to control
me. No, I can't
share it. You know what my socks are?
Wow, that is quite the statement.
Yeah, where are my Mets socks? I need them for fantasy camp.
Why can't you just wear the socks you have on?
Well, that's a great idea. So when they divide up teams down there, they'll be like, okay, we'll take the dude with the eye patch. You can have the sad guy with the regular socks.
That's cute that you think socks are the reason you get picked last.
I've worked for 20 years for this moment. I want to look the part.
And you will, but I need your opinion on something first, okay?
Fine.
Okay.
Pick my brain.
So, I'm about to get this promotion at work.
Uh-huh.
I know it. Everybody knows it. But when they make the announcement, I want to, like, look surprised and then humble, you know? I've been working on it in the mirror, so just tell me what you think, all right? Tell me I got the promotion.
In the new... whatever the thing is, goes to... Donna Gable.
Oh, my God.
Okay. You gotta take it down a notch.
What?
Your eyebrows, they're everything's all over the place.
Okay, but I can't just stand there like an idiot. I gotta do something.
Just do what I do. I go from double guns into prayer hands under the chin. I do a face bow and out into a point. Like, what's up?
I like that.
Yeah, whatever, where are my socks? Come on.
Oh, you know? On top of the dryer.
Oh, all right, thanks.
Wait.
Yeah. I said it before, but I really mean it this time. This is what it's all about.
And you're sure you're okay watching Harry's show?
Yeah, I mean, he's a good guy. You know, it just didn't work out with me and all. I mean, being here with you, nothing can hurt me.
You know, one of my big thrills is discovering new talent, and this one's As Good As It Gets with her new single, Yes Indeedy, my good friend, Dee Dee Goodman.
Resistance. We both been to this place. I want it all, but I don't want to be greedy. Ooh, if you're asking for my.
I go
care why that stings a little. I just can't stop thinking about it. I blew it.
Well, maybe it's not as bad as you think.
I'm his driver, and the guy left without me. It's pretty bad.
Can you just apologize to him tomorrow?
He's not going to be it tomorrow, Donna. He hasn't called me. Yeah, it's probably for the best. I tell you, driving a celebrity, it's just too much pressure, you know? And besides, this is the whole reason I retired right here, right? Just spend time, you and I. It's nice. That's him!
Oh, my God.
Hello? Hello? Hey, Harry. Tomorrow, I gotta check my schedule. Yeah, looks like we're good. I'll see you then. Kenny G is back!
Well, that's gonna sting for a while.
Yep. Bye-bye, pizza boat.
That's the takeaway from this? The pizza boat?
It's the front runner right now, yes.
You're unbelievable.
I don't know what you want us to do, all right? I mean, nobody wants to hang out with us.
Us?
You're saying it was me?
Babe, I don't want to hurt your feelings, but 100% yes.
What? Okay, well, since we're taking feelings off the table, I'm gonna tell you right now, I've been carrying this team for years.
Carrying us?
Yeah.
With what? Your stupid jokes? Okay, and maybe if you listened instead of interrupting me,
I'm doing you a favor. I am like the music at an award show, a gentle reminder to wrap things up.
Okay. Well, at least I didn't blow it with the swingers.
You don't think that was me? Really? No. I don't want to do this. I didn't want to bring it up, but at the restaurant, they couldn't take their eyes off me.
None of us could. You had a piece of linguine on your chin for over an hour.
It wasn't the linguine. They were looking at me like, oh, I love it. Look at him. They were like, oh, look at him. Even the waiter was walking by like, oh, look at that. Oh, he did like one of these.
Okay, well, if they were so into you, were they texting you? Because they've been blowing up my phone since they left.
I don't know. Let me check. Aha! In your face!
They texted you.
No, but Frank from the deli did.
Ah, what are we doing? Why are we turning on each other?
Look, you're right. I'm sorry, all right?